Essence.
We out here, man.
We out here, man. The MisBelief radio show.
Yep, and the Fly With Bats podcast.
Fly With Bats podcast. We about to go document some shit, y'all niggas. Shout out to my brother in the back. He got to go to work, man.
It's Saturday, though, and Sunday, I will be blessed for S.
But, you'll be blessed for S.
Essence for Essence.
Welcome to the concrete jungle. Hey, I've been at my lowest before, to tell you the truth. Not a pot of pissy and all a window to throw it through. I broke a shattered glass. Money tight is too small shoes. Depending on my mouth.
What's happening, y'all? What's happening? Welcome to the MisBelief radio show live on WBOK 1230 AM. I just lied to you just now. I lied to you. We ain't live and we ain't at the studio.
Baby.
Because you just saw me 30 minutes ago at Essence Fest. That's why. You saw me and Martin at Essence Fest looking good. Mm-hmm. Somehow we also on the air at the same time. So this is DC Paul, the Millennial Arsenio. And I'm always here with a creative cast of cool kids, collectively criminals. And other C words, whatever. I'm usually much better at this. But you know what? I'm swinging my thing anyway. And I swing it to the left side, and who that is?
Well, since we don't know our lefts from our rights at the moment, I'm just going to take it. This is boy, that actor guy, Martin Bass Bradford, back in this mug.
Welcome back, man. And you know what's funny? He ain't even to my immediate left.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying?
He's not.
He just knew how to jump right on in there. But to my immediate left, who that is?
What's up, y'all? It's Jay Steele, keeping it real. How y'all doing? We doing good.
Yeah, we doing good, man. We keeping it real. We actually at my house, so we keeping it so real.
Keeping it extremely real.
I have no idea. I ain't got no drawers on.
Hey.
He's not lying. None.
That's what you call dedication right there.
It's pure dedication.
On the floor in my new house. Ain't got no furniture.
We could have gave y'all a rerun.
No drawers.
Right. No drawers either. But I'm swinging my thing anyway with these no drawers on. I'm swinging to the right side.
I bet. Hi,
everyone. Hey, the one and only Oshun. You know, I've met about 3 other Oshuns since we've been doing this radio show.
No.
So you can't be the one and only.
No, he's lying.
No, I'm telling the God honest truth.
No.
That's fine. And we got, one of my favorite people sitting as a co-host this week. Man, introduce yourself to the people.
How y'all doing? This is the executive producer, the one and only, fresh about the gumbo, Alpha Joe, from the Fly With Bats podcast. Here to just drop a couple of knowledge for you cats out there. And, you know, as long as I don't get swung on a little cunnilingus, I'll be all right, you know?
Yeah,
you might get swung on with a little cunnilingus, you heard me.
You know what, you know?
Absolutely possible.
As long as it come with a little analingus, you know?
A little analingus.
Wow.
I don't know what we can say, but wow. Shouts out to Madani Graves and Mastermind and Malik, you heard me?
And India Mac. Yeah, all of our MisBelievers.
98% of the time.
No,
we ain't gonna talk about that. We ain't gonna talk about that last 2%. No, that was a 2% that we caught
her
on.
And that's her bougie side. Don't forget about her bougie side. You're right.
You know I'm bougie.
Right. So, man, you know we ain't got canceled yet. The reason why is because, I mean, I'm sure if y'all are listening, if y'all have been listening, you know I'm very inappropriate. Very inappropriate. But at my heart, I am a wordsmith. I know how to dance on the line without crossing the line, right? Tip on the tightrope, like Janelle Monáe say, right? See, I know how to get sexy with the psyche, so try me. You would most likely like me because I be the cunning linguist who pokes and penetrates with a pen, not a penis. I'm talking poetically. So just listen and let me lyrically lick you till you come to a climax unexpectedly. But you'd better be readily available to receive it raw. I mean, mentally spread eagle on your back arch, drop your jaw and leave your lips open because every emotion coming over you, your face is going to show. And that's only one of those places I can go. So I'm just saying, I'm a nasty,
wait,
nasty
hold
poet.
We come to your house and now you want to spit poetry.
Yeah.
It's like he has the robe, he has the mug full of Joe and a little bit of, you know,
cognac.
You have your pipe. Right, like
the ascot.
He has the ascot, not the mandals, but the slippers.
I have to explain to the people why, you know, I get away with saying stuff because I know what I can say. You know what I'm saying? Like I tip on the tightrope. You know what I'm saying? Lickety split.
Lickety split. Huh?
You know what I'm saying? Just like that, and I'm in and I'm out, just like that.
In and
you
out.
Know,
man.
So that's why I ain't got canceled yet. Not Five Guys. Come on.
No.
Come on. Now you're the one being inappropriate, Alpha Man Joe. But we got a pretty good show for y'all, man. This is the Essence Fest edition, so...
The Essence Fest edition.
Thank you for the sound effects.
Right.
I thought I had the deepest voice on this show.
Give him the drums. drop?
Hell yeah, man. So you gonna catch me and Mr. Bats out there at Essence Fest representing the MisBelief and the Fly with Bats podcast.
Oh, dude.
Well, to hear me. Fly with Bats. Essence Fest.
We was going on out here.
Y'all was going on out here, man. Come on, let me hold the camera and you walk, son, dude. So they see what you... How you rocking, son? You got the fro hog going. You got the cleavage, you heard me?
Got the meavage, baby.
The meavage.
Yeah. Gotta get it on.
Outchea.
Like you said, Fly with Bats, MisBelief, Essence. The guy's sick.
Man, 2017, sick, man. It's... Yeah. Big things happening, you hear me? How y'all doing?
Speaking of podcasts, man, shout out to our two sister podcasts, the Fly with Bats podcast, yeah, but also Triliterate. We also saw them out there last night at the festival.
Sonny D and Petty Mayonnaise.
Yeah, man, cool people, man.
We're not going to say your government name, Petty Mayonnaise. he told me
it was last night. I had no idea. I had to ask him, like, bro, I feel bad calling you Petty Mayonnaise to your face. Like, what do I call you?
Yo, Petty.
Right?
Mayonnaise.
Yeah, man.
He told me
that's my
name.
Dude, P. Right. Mayo.
So, yeah, man, check out the Fly with Bats podcast, the MisBelief podcast, and Triliterate podcast. We're all available on iTunes, Stitcher, Slicer, and wherever else you should get your podcast from. I think I made up Slicer.
Stitcher is Slicer, real, though.
Stitcher is real.
Okay.
Slicer is not real. That might be like a okay. Kind of Tinder.
That might be some screwed some up
people,
Tinder.
Some people get their podcast on Scissor. If you're getting it on Scissor.
No.
Oh, no. Scissor. That's that lesbian dating app. Scissor,
yeah,
right? Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm sorry.
That lesbian dating app.
Oh, it's where the actors meet.
And I tell you a story about the time he made a profile for me on there, and he used my picture, and he put a profile for me on his dating app because he wanted to see what it was like.
Yeah, I wanted to see what it was like, and I didn't want to use, like, a random person's face. Like,
right.
If I'm going to hurt somebody's feelings, I got to know whose feelings I'm hurting, right? So I made a
I'm with you, Oshun. He should have found some random picture right. on Google
so,
Images and
so
put her face up there.
Poor Oshun. Well, it's been happening for a long time, people.
We both made, like, three new friends from that app, so I'm just saying, look, don't give me the eye. They was all nice people. Anyway, man.
Thank you so much.
So I was saying, man, we got a good episode for you. I'm interviewing T-Ray the Violinist. He's so busy. This is a pre-recorded episode with a pre-recorded interview. That's how busy out here, you heard me? What else you got, man? Oh, we playing so much music from people who are representing at Essence Fest. Yep. T-Ray sent me his new single from his 90s R&B violin mixtape.
You did.
Shout out.
That's dope.
Hold up, DC Paul. Bringing back his what?
It is a 90s R&B violin mixtape.
His what?
90s R&B violin mixtape. Who else is doing that but a NOLA millennial representing?
Nobody.
A NOLA black millennial at that, man. Ooh, we representing out here. Come on, man. You heard me? So he's going to drop his interview on us later. We're going to talk about what's going on out here.
Yeah, man.
Bats is going to drop that neck on somebody.
Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm. Oshun is going to close us out with a Sankofa session.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we're going to play music from people who are rocking at Essence Fest. Upcoming, who we got? I think this is something by Master P, huh?
Man, Master P, you know, he got the celebrity basketball joint.
Yeah, that was
on
Friday, yeah.
So, Coach, you're 19 points ahead.
Yeah.
How are you going to keep the team's head in the game?
You know, we've got to keep the momentum up. We've got to keep the fans going. New Orleans in the building. We just gonna keep doing what we gotta do. It's all the love gonna keep it going for us.
And and he's also been in the city helping out with philanthropy. He's been putting money into getting certain spots built up.
He's doing philanthropy.
My dude, Master P, Mr. Miller.
Really?
Giving
I thought he was a Scientologist. He's doing philanthropy. Philanthropy means something else. Sorry. Oh, no, I just made that up.
Yeah, man. Yeah. I'm glad we let that be known because, you know, Master P. Master P went to the Breakfast Club in New York and told them, look here, what y'all not gonna do.
True, P. Listen, I know you don't know me. Get to know me, man. I just be saying stuff.
He don't mean no harm. It's all
right. Yeah, I ain't gonna say no more, Playboy. You got me. You ain't gotta say nothing. You got me.
And if you need somebody to play Silk the Shocker in your bio, P.
DC Paul is your man.
Yeah, man. Master P and the whole No Limit crew is doing a reunion. Is that tomorrow?
I believe it's tomorrow at Essence. So in honor of the reunion, we gonna be playing some No Limit.
Yes, sir.
Some classic No Limit throughout this episode.
We're gonna drop some Mia X on it for the Black Girl Magic. Black Girl Magic.
Black Girl Magic.
Are you the biggest mama me?
No, not me, no.
That's because you've been losing some weight recently. I thought you was...
No.
You the medium mama.
Medium.
The medium Mamma Mia. That's Slim the three M's. Yeah.
All right, man. We playing around. We're going to take a break. You heard me. We're going to play a track by No Limit. Stick around. Stay tuned to the MisBelief Radio Show on WBOK AM 1230. And we'll be right back. Don't get nothing on you.
God, but your grandma, you heard bitch. Me.
What's happening, y'all? DC Cole. That actor guy, Bats. You heard me. We at the Essence Fest. We in the dome with the press passes. Let's see how this goes. It's a shame that nothing interesting is happening already. Let's see, beautiful people here.
We say you body body, I represent. We're them killers, hey. Third wall, Kelly, your projects, we got our own thing. This is small hood, but it's all good. And Mr. Rogers ain't got nothing on my neighborhood. I represent nothing but cheese. From Richmond, California, all the way back to New Orleans.
We don't know where to go yet.
Right. No clue at all.
We just walked in this bitch, Jeremy. I think it's supposed to be all access passes, so what up, Blair? Proud of you, my man.
Who else that shout out to? Kenitra.
Kenitra?
Tremaine.
What up, Tremaine? Turl. See, Bass, bro, you see, you got the chest out.
The Meevich. The Meevich, you heard me.
Some of y'all been asleep, and while y'all were sleeping, they switched presidents. So I come up to tell you to wake up, and the president ought to be looking at New Orleans, but this is how you treat women the way we treat them at Essence.
Skinnier than me.
What?
You see that?
He need to be busting the Meevich.
Yeah, he do. So he could use a blouse like you got with some cleavage, blouse, man. That's a blouse. That bitch button all the way down to the belly button, son?
I mean, you pushing the pounds, you feel?
Sexy, flexy ass nigga. Okay, we're gonna take a walk around, you heard me? Then I'm gonna go live when something interesting is happening. But in the meantime, they say John Legend, Diana Ross, and sexy, sexy people. All in the building. See y'all in a minute.
We're back. Welcome back to the MisBelief Radio Show. Live.
Live.
Live. That call.
Live. Live-ish. Right. Well, right. Well.
Right. We are live.
At some point in time.
I know. I feel like this is the live-ish episode.
It's right. Live-ish.
The live-ish episode.
That's the name of the podcast.
Live-ish. Yep, the live-ish.
So the Essence man, Fest, the Essence Fest live-ish episode.
It is Essence Fest weekend. Oshun, I see you got the Essence Fest app open.
Yes, I'm looking to see what's actually going to be happening later on. Yeah, man.
Download the Essence Fest app. It have all kind of updates about things going on at the Convention Center as well as the Superdome and around the city. So download that thing. It's free. You hear me? And just catch me and Bats out there.
And you know, like we got to get into our, you know, we had an adventure last night.
Oh,
you did.
We did. Man. And we was out there at the Superdome.
So, we're sitting here recording.
Yep.
And I had to stop. Because the door was, somebody knocking at the door. Mm-hmm. I thought it was my ride, because y'all know I'm leaving a little bit to go to slide down. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, it's the Romper Lady.
It's the Romper Lady.
With the new delivery.
DC has a personal Romper Lady.
The Romper is here.
Fresh from Africa.
He's like, oh my God, I'm excited. So he was like, where are we trying it on at? I thought he was going to get naked right here. So he could try on the romper. When I tell you, it's the loudest romper you ever seen. Mm-hmm. It's a multitude of African colors. Mm-hmm. He is going to be the livest and the shyest. I don't even know if he's wearing it tonight or tomorrow.
I mean, he just said he's going to get it tonight. He said Essence Fest. He's been saying it for weeks, y'all. Yeah. He's been saying it on the show. He's been saying it in general that, no, I'm getting this romper.
I'm getting my Kente cloth romper. And it's about to happen.
He only wanted two things, his TV and his Kente cloth romper. Mm-hmm. And guess what, baby? The TV is behind me and the Kente Glow
Rapper is
in the room.
So,
you can't make this up.
So when y'all see DC at Essence Fest, make sure, man.
No, we're not doing anything.
Man, I'm about to go have a cigarette.
Y'all make sure y'all take a picture with him and his Kente Glow Rapper, because he's been.
It's going to be epic.
He's been going
and
through
make it. Make sure when you take a picture, make sure you post it Romper Realness. Mm-hmm. Hashtag Romper Realness. All I want to see all the hashtags. Romper Realness. This is
going to
be live. Exclusive.
And also, hashtag Paul Essence. You're going to get this Paul Essence. For Essence.
And boy, DC, by the way, a walking bottle Egyptian mask.
Well, I guess we're going to have to see.
Oh my gosh. Oh my
God. He is a witness.
So,
man, this is
I guess while DC Paul tries on his romp, I guess.
We're, yeah, man, I saw your fabric.
We're going to break.
It's beautiful.
We're going to break, y'all. This is Oshun, J Step, Alpha Joe.
Word.
And Mr.
And Bats. DC in his Kente cloth romper.
You got that.
Hey, we'll be back. Let's get back.
They're about to go for day 3.
Day 3, you heard
MisBelief Radio MisBelief Radio Show.
And the Fly With Bats podcast.
You heard me? Representing. Yes, shouts out to Alpha Joe. Know what you were saying, DC? We on some Black Boy Joy for the weekend.
Yeah, man. Black Boy Joy for the weekend. Black Boy Fly all evening. You heard me?
You did.
I'm bad. He's bougie. And this is how we just have a rocket. Just trying our best to sexify up tonight, you heard me?
So we, you know, we about to do this last night, about to go out with a bang, see what we can capture, see what we can catch.
Hey, so on the side note, right, if you know me, you know I got a real tiny bladder and I drink quite a bit, right? So when I be out and about, I end up having to piss outside a whole lot, right?
A lot.
But now I got the romper on.
Oh.
I ain't finna strip naked just to piss outside every 15 minutes. I gotta figure something out. Ladies, got any tips? Let me know how to wear a romper and take a piss. If you need to. Yeah, right. Alright, we're gonna cut it off before we die. Before Alpha go kill himself.
Nah, you butt naked, y'all.
How my boots looking in front?
You looking alright? Sit, boy, in that romper.
For me? Go see.
Martin Betts Bradford with the Imperials on.
Oh, man, we're at the DC Paul. He made these things famous.
Betts got them fresh. Fresh off the motherland.
That romper skin was what made it fly, bro. See, I be faking it. Trying to be all peanut butter and it's African print.
I be.
He said peanut butter is African.
They say I be overcompensating. It's not true. I just really like it. But if I look like that, I can't take calls every day here. And it will be able to tell me shit about it.
Not a goddamn thing.
Black ass.
And we back, man. So it's a damn shame we ain't doing Facebook Live for this episode, because this romper, let me tell you, my glutes look so good in that thing, you heard me? So good. I can't wait. I can't wait to catch me out at the Essence Fest. Hopefully Sunday night. I'm gonna be rocking it.
You're gonna be rocking it.
That thing.
Alright. So as we get into the Essence Fest edition of the What's Going On Out Chip, you hear me? Like I was saying before we went on our romper break, me and DC Paul went on, we had an adventure yesterday for the first night out, because you know we got credentials this year.
Yeah, man. They gave us a press pass. They done effed up and gave us a press pass. I can say effed up.
You can say effed up. They fornicated it up. You feel me?
So we tried to abuse that press pass in every way possible.
Yes.
We went into the press room.
Yes.
Who we saw in the press room? Rhonda Ross.
Yeah, Donna Ross' daughter. Yes.
MC Light.
We saw MC Light. That was a cool one. Oh, no, we go back. Rhonda Ross shouted out Tank.
Oh,
and
she sure did, man. That was so dope. Other artists you would
like to work with? There are lots of artists I would like to work with. There are almost so many, it doesn't even make sense to start naming them, but I love India Irie, who just went off. Two of the songs on my record is called In Case You Didn't Know. Two of the songs I wrote with Shannon Sanders out of Nashville, who works with India. I'm hoping I can catch him downstairs. I love Jill Scott, I love Erica. There's a New Orleans group, Tank and the Bangas.
Oh, yes.
What?
Yes, indeed.
What?
You said that.
They take me out. I love them so much. I love Kendrick Lamar. I mean, the list is long of who I would love to play with. Yeah, I'd love to collaborate with everybody. You know what I mean? There's some good music out there.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Rhonda, for your
Thank
time.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. I really appreciate it.
Daughter
of the boss.
So
up next, guys, we have MC Light.
She shouted out your favorite group. How you
shout out my favorite group? I felt like she was trying to connect with me when she said that. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you know what? You knew I was standing here. That's why you said it. You want to impress me. But you know what, Rhonda Ross? I'm not impressed.
was she who you asked the question to?
I know, oh, yeah, man. Well, Oshun was watching the Facebook Live when we were in the press room with Rhonda Ross, and Oshun told me to ask.
Yes.
Hi, I'm DC Paul from WBOK. One of our listeners wants to know if you've ever thought about acting.
I guess because she was thinking about like Tracy Ellis Ross and Diana Ross doing some acting, so she assumed that the other Ross daughter had not done any acting.
Right.
And her response was,
I am an Emmy nominated actress,
so
thank you very much.
All right.
Yes, I've thought about it. Yes, I'm an actor also. I practice the arts. I practice the arts in all their forms. I practice the arts in my life. I practice the arts as I am parenting my 7-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
I practice the arts, and so I express myself through the arts. So singing, songwriting, producing, acting, writing for the stage. I've written screenplays. I've directed the stage plays. I like to express myself through all of the ways that are at my fingertips.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I think about acting.
Thank you very much. Oshun, if you're watching, you want to know if you thought about acting. She's an Emmy-nominated actress, so she told you. So take that.
And then when she did that, I Googled it. I was like, oh, she sure is.
don't be doubting that. Raw. All the Rosses are acting. The son, the two daughters.
Hey, that's talented family.
I didn't know
she
that either, Josef. That's
not
enough.
It's Chauncey and
Artifah Barry.
Rhonda.
Rhonda.
And Rhonda Ross actually performed at Essence Fest yesterday, so
what?
She has a musical career as well.
And yep. She let us know all that she does.
I'm an actor.
I am an artist.
I'm an artist.
Because she said, don't just be trying. Don't ask me about what I already do. That's almost like asking her, hey, dude, you gonna probably sing? You sing? That's how she felt. That's how she took it. If we asked her, do she sing?
You don't know my mama.
Right.
So. We talked to Rhonda Ross. We talked to Indy Irie.
Indy Irie had a great. She was so down to earth.
Yeah,
Indy Irie.
Beautiful.
She smelled so woke.
Oh, like, I believe it.
Jojoba Earl, just all up and through the room, man.
Oh, thank you for asking.
So I haven't been really touring much for the last couple years, but that's because I've been working on developing all of this stuff. So I developed something called the Songversation Practice, and it involves breathing and stretching and prayer and meditation to get yourself into the flow of your work. And so I say it's a spiritual practice for creativity, but I always like to remind people that life is a creative endeavor. So it's just about life and how to get yourself into the flow. And the reason why I wanted to do that is because I believe that the things that people create from the flow are more healing for everyone. So my mission, early in my career, I created a mission statement because I wanted to keep track of why I did what I did. So my whole Grammy thing was weird and the music industry was weird and I was gonna quit. And I was like, wait a minute, why do I do this? So my mission statement for my whole career, almost 20 years, has been to spread love, healing, peace, and joy through the power of words and music. I don't assume that I can do it, I just feel like, why not try? Because we always need healing. And so with what's happened, so creating the Songversation Practice really is a matured expression of who I've always been. When I was younger, I came out when I was 24 years old. And so at that time, I didn't feel bold enough to say, we should pray. We should pray, even pray for your songs. Pray before you start drawing. Pray before you start writing your article. Like, you know, because why not? Like, I wouldn't even say the word prayer on stage. And I pray a lot for everything all the time. And so anyway, getting to a place where I felt mature enough and confident enough and eloquent enough to express my concepts. That is what Songversation came out of. But also, it's the work I've always tried to do in my work, in my songwriting. And so, people think meditation is this. Oh, and you gotta do something with your hands. And it can be, but meditation is like sports. So there's basketball, and there's baseball, there's snowshoeing, there's all kind of things, right? There's all kinds of ways to meditate. But the truth, the main thing is that meditation is about stillness. We don't sit still enough in our lives. And I feel like what we all know is that we comprise the world we live in. So we're out there trying to make it a better place, but we need to make ourselves better first, because you're more powerful when you are your best, right? And so the Songversation Practice is really a way to help people be their best. So say a little prayer, do a little meditation before you go in the street and march, right? Because then that makes you powerful as 10 people. And so I don't, again, assume that I can make anybody do anything. I'm just offering my part. And I feel like for whoever that resonates for, that they're gonna see the elevation in their effectiveness in everything for who this Songversation Practice resonates for. It's not for everybody, but I just am trying because this is what I have to use and I'm trying to help myself be better. It's something that I've discovered, that breathing and stretching and praying, like little tiny stretch. We know how you do this. That little tiny stuff, when you think about it in the context of your work and your life, can take you so far. So I just hope to help somebody be better. I don't know, you know.
And she had somebody who specifically was there to take off her shoes and put some sandals on.
Yep.
Right?
Okay, but wait, we're about to change.
We about to change your shoes and y'all get to take of the queen.
I'm not changing my shoe. No, get out of the way. No. Too late, you should have been eating that pie.
That actually happened.
It took him like 30 minutes, but he or she.
That was
I'm
a
not
woman.
Sure.
That was definitely
I'm not
a
sure.
woman.
That person.
It was a woman. He's calling this
oh,
woman.
No,
Joe,
it's just person.
This person.
We're going to say this person for the
this,
time.
This
they.
Beautiful soul.
They.
Ginger neutral.
That's what
Ginger
they neutral. Did. But what was funny is this. They did that for the picture, but she was telling her, I don't need that. Like, that's how I thought
oh,
she.
Right,
she
yeah.
didn't even want to have. She's like, you got to do all that. And then after it was done, she was like, well, it do look good.
Right. Uh-huh. And then somebody asked her to sing, and she wanted to, but that person kind of told her not to. So, right. Like, oh. She's like real downer. Yeah, I mean, that person
is so funny. For us.
Singer, oh, don't get me started singing.
Yay!
Oh wait, do I have time to sing?
And she wanted to, but that person kind of told her not to. So right. Like, oh. She's like real downer. Yeah, I mean, that person probably was her handler who was like, listen,
we got
you know,
we on the time.
These are just the free interviews that we're doing. You ain't coming to sing for these people, right? Ain't no yin yang around the house for these folk. Mm-hmm. Facebook Live.
Now, an MC Light interview, one thing that was a standout, they asked her who would they want to play her in the movie.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Great answer, she said.
Oh, that's an interesting question. She talked about a biopic. Who would I choose to pick me? You know, for me, I would want Lil Mama, but because she's done Left Eye already, it might be a little, you know, difficult to make happen. But I think if we wait a few years, yeah. But I am in development with Lemmy Plummer, with L Plummer Media, to do the biopic. Thank you for that question.
She said only reason why she would be apprehensive is because Lil Mama played Left Eye. Yeah.
And that's when I said Chadwick Boseman is playing everybody. Right. So let Lil Mama play all the women. Let her beat up women that rap. I mean, come on, it's the best of them and everybody. Right. So, because Lil Mama looked more like MC Light than Left Eye.
Yeah, but I would say let it go to the most qualified actress. You know, if it's not Lil Mama, you know, let it be, you know, whoever can carry that role. Because she got a story to tell, man. Oh, she was there with her reverend, who apparently had changed her life a couple years back.
MC Light?
Yeah.
Michael Lewis, Austin, Texas. I was down in Las Vegas when you was at the Steve Harvey Neighborhood Awards or so, and you spoke about your foundation.
Yes.
Could you speak about it a little bit more? I think it's very important, a project that you have.
Absolutely. It's called the Hip Hop Sisters Foundation. My signature initiative is hashtag educate our men, and whereby we give scholarships away to young men, to young black men to be specific, to right now our partnership is with Dillard University. And so we've given away nearly $800,000 in scholarships. The president and COO of Hip Hop Sisters Foundation is here, Reverend Dr. Lynn Richardson. You know, I need a reverend to keep me in order, help change my life. You wanna say something to the people?
Praise the Lord. No, I just have to say, I'm so proud of Light. When I walked into her enterprise 6 years ago, the dream was for her to be everything that everybody sees today. So to see her loving the Lord, giving back to the community, helping young men go to school, the voice of the BET Awards for the 10th year in a row. That's our Super Bowl, you know, event, and also getting married. Now, praise the Lord one more time for that. To a beautiful dog. But she's talking about having kids. I'm like, hold on. We got stuff to do. I ain't got time to be walking no babies around, all of that. But this is my sister. She is my sister, and I love her, and I love what she stands for, and I'm so happy that you all are happy for her.
Let's do some photos, Lynn.
So, beautiful woman. Oh, you know who did sing for us live? Kelly Price.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh.
So why send depression, not blessings? Why, oh, why you do me wrong? You persecute the weak because it makes you feel so strong. I don't have much strength to fight, so I look to the light to make my wrong seem right. Head up high, I look to the light. Yes, cause I know that you'll make everything all right. Yes, and I know that you'll take good care of your child. Oh, I'm no longer afraid of the night. So I look to the light. Woo!
Kelly Price, I went to bed at like 4 a.m. because we got in a little car accident last night. But I went to bed at 4 a.m. and I was still feeling Kelly Price chills down my back. It was real, man.
SD.
Yeah, she just sang.
It was beautiful because first we saw her at the lounge joint.
Super lounge,
and it was fire. She was singing that old joint with R. Kelly Mr. Biggs. Oh. And she said, y'all sing the Mr. Big R. Kelly part. Everybody knew all the words.
Everybody knew all the words.
I'm an audience to represent for Mr. Biggs. And I need the white hat. I'm an audience to represent for R. Kelly. Tell me, can you do that? Are you ready? Are you ready? It's the phone call. Here we go. Sing.
This is Mr. B.
You got it. I'm trying to protect her heart. Check out the foolery. She may have been a fool to you, but to me, she is a star. I wanna know. Oh why, oh why, oh why? Oh why, oh why, oh why? Thank you. That's incredible. That is my time. I love you.
Man, I had sang that song in at least a decade.
And yeah, about since high school.
But you know what? We all knew all the words. Mm-hmm. And this is Mr. Big. How you doing,
Mr. Big?
Yeah, oh. No. The whole audience was on it, man. It was nice.
Kelly telling me that you were sleeping with another one. Just because I'm talking to... No, just because you see me with it doesn't mean I'm sleeping with it.
Well, if you're not sleeping with her, what the you doing with her?
Well, maybe I was just talking with her.
Or you could be just creeping with her. Yeah, man, yo, Kelly Price, she got so many hits, man. But the whole audience was in their feelings, man. And she brought it back to He Was a Friend of Mine.
I'm glad we got.
Oh my gosh, that's my favorite.
I never even been in that situation, but I felt I was like, man, whoever that woman is, like, to hell with her.
It's because we got Big Kelly back. I think that's what it is.
She put on that weight. She put that weight on.
And it looked good on her. I mean, like she looked good with it. It did, because at one point she got like really, really, really slim, and then she fell off. And I was like,
she lost her essence. Huh? Mm. You gotta keep that on.
You gotta keep that essence, baby. So like you said, Kelly, she sang live at the press conference. At the press thing, huh?
Well, we didn't catch her whole set at the Super Lounge, but I mean, she had better done as we lay. But so she sang at the in the press room for us. Who else we caught in there? Was that all?
I think that's all the ones we caught in the press room, because we kept on going in and out of it.
Yeah, we was in and out. The backstage access. We didn't even know we got the all access, the VIP and the backstage.
All access. He was like, can we go back here? He's like, yeah, y'all could go anywhere.
It's gonna be hard not to abuse it. Oh, but then we went backstage and saw Anthony Anderson. Mm-hmm. Oh, this was a part of the adventure. Oh. So we didn't know exactly what our badges allowed us to do, right?
He got on that Exhibit B shirt, so I know that. The Studio B shirt. Shout out to B Mike Odom, putting his product out there, man.
That's
where
you
can get it. That's the VIP All Access. I'm scared to walk up to that because they tell me we don't have access. It's going to be a problem. But you want to do that thing anyway, Badge? You want to give it a try, bro?
What?
That's VIP All Access Lounge.
Let's see if we can just roll up in that bit.
That's Badge. Let's roll up in that bit.
Okay, we're going to try to get in this here. They say All Access VIP Lounge. Really, we're going to test it out ourselves. No, say wristband. The tag on your wristband.
The wristbandless.
I feel like it's tag this on this. This little thing right here. You wanna try it? Tap it on there, see if it happens.
Watch this failure.
Not pressed.
No. That's why I didn't want
to
do it.
That's why I was out the pool. They said you got to wait for motherfuckers to come out.
Oh. We thought it was an all access. So right there.
It's majority access.
It's majority access because they got these special VIP lounges that we are not allowed to get into. Now, I was scared to go approach them because I didn't want to get embarrassed.
My face is still on the floor in the Superdome right now. Oh, but it's
all good, man, because we could go to like 98% of the Superdome.
And then, no. People else we got curved by, if you want to talk about getting curved. So we walk in and we all of a sudden we see the dude who played Ralph in the new edition movie.
What was his name?
I forget his name. LG Smith. LG Smith. So we see him and he's small. He's really little.
Oh, that boy was tiny.
He little.
No offense to small people, but he was tiny. Yeah.
So we see him, hugging women. What you about to say?
Shorter than me?
Yeah, he might be a little shorter than you, but he's thin, so it makes him look even smaller.
Oh, wow.
You feel me? But like, you know, but he looked just how he looked on some level. So you know the women, you know, they, when they recognize him, they like, yeah, ooh, you know, they catching the pictures with him. So DC go, he like, you think we could get a quick interview with him? What you think? I don't know. You feel me? I don't know. Like, he seemed like he more interested in, you know, these women around here. Like, we had India Mack or Oshun or Jay Steele.
I wish we would have had a woman with us.
A woman. He would have talked to one of y'all. Cause
he would have felt more.
What's the shirt unbuttoned?
he might have been slightly on bubble.
I think it was. Mm-hmm.
And I mean, he might have had that Meebage going on, but definitely so like, so DC, like, I guess since he made me take the lick at the VIP lounge, he decided he was going
to
take the lick.
Yeah, I had to.
With Lil Ralph Transvant, with Lil Ralph.
Oh.
You feel me? So he ain't go up to Ralph. He went up to his handler.
The handler, yeah. And he didn't even make eye contact with me. He shook his head like, are you serious?
You have a penis.
We're right.
That's what it felt like.
And I was like, you know what? I'm the millennial Arsenio. And he didn't care.
He did not
care.
I said, you don't follow me on Facebook? What?
I feel like he didn't even hear the question. He just saw dudes, and it was like,
he shook his head, no.
Nah, because every woman that approached, young, old, didn't matter. He put that smile on. He gave them that time. You
pictures
feel me?
And everything.
Everything.
Sure did.
So I'm like, we can't get one question, dog. Feel me? Actor to actor?
Right.
Get your ass out of here.
Straight up. You feel me? I'm trying to think what else happened because it was just a funny night. Like,
it was a good night, man. We saw The Boss, Miss Diana Ross.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? I've never thought that wasn't ever one of my like bucket list moments. Like, right. I got to see Diana Ross. But now that I've seen it, I feel like I can scratch that off of somebody's bucket list, right? I mean, I may never see Diana Ross live again.
I fell into a legend.
And you saw the sea of people who were singing her songs and had they like waving their hands in the air like Diana Ross. I guess there was like the Rihanna of
Japanese
icon. Was that the Rihanna of that decade?
Yes. Okay. Yes. And pops were at the Diana Ross concert, and that's all they could talk about. There was any sway, and there was everywhere. There was like actually everybody over 40 that I saw on my Facebook timeline just couldn't stop talking about that.
Mm-hmm. 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 And you know what? I ain't gonna lie. When she first got on stage, I accused her of lip syncing. I turned her back. I said she lip syncing.
Mm-hmm.
After a while, I realized that no, she wasn't.
She was not.
She was singing live. And I'm sorry, Miss Ross.
If she lip synced, she lip synced that one song because the rest of that whole night.
Yeah, she was singing live. She definitely was. Man, it was a good show, man. I'm looking forward to going to Essence Fest tonight.
Shout out to John Legend.
Oh, John Legend did his thing.
Killed it.
He got so many hits too, man.
Yeah, and then one of the most funniest things to see at that joint is how many of the workers are just jammed out.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like people working security, people working all over. They just
especially
jammed
the
out.
Working on the floor. They got the best seats or spots,
standing
stands,
positions,
spaces.
Oh, yeah, man. But you know, we ain't just doing the Superdome. We're also doing the convention center, the some of the empowerment seminars. I'm looking forward to tomorrow when they do all of the gospel stuff. You know, I'm gonna do my little blazing worship, and then I'm gonna go into the convention center and feel the Lord.
Do you know what they're doing tomorrow though?
What?
They are giving a tribute to Sissy Houston.
Yes.
Oh,
they
wow.
Are.
They okay.
are going to be rocking the house. It's going to be so good.
I think I saw that on Essence Fest app.
Is
going
to be leading that lineup.
Oh.
Cece Winans, Kelly Price.
Okay, you know what?
PJ Morton.
Yeah.
Wait, hold up, pause. Who is that singer that got in trouble for singing the wrong song at the gospel?
Kelly Price.
Okay, I was just making sure that's what I heard.
She
right.
sang as we lay at a gospel thing. She did. She sure did.
She was wrong for that.
Because as soon as I said gospel, I went, Kelly Price. Kelly I was Price. Like, wait a minute. Spidey sis just went off. Something's wrong with that.
Church to a church middle. They wouldn't let me sing as we lay. Just cheating for infidelity song.
Yeah, but I'm looking forward to that tomorrow morning in the convention center. I'm getting some gospel in my life. You know what I'm saying? And then that night. Who's tomorrow night? Is it Chance the Rapper?
Yes.
Oh, Chance the Rapper tomorrow night.
He also do a little gospel-ish type thing.
He's gonna give me my the word.
Yeah.
Because I'm not always into the gospel songs, but like, you know what I mean, my poets, talk to me.
Yeah, man. Yeah. So we looking forward to it. Catch us out there. You probably just saw us 30 minutes ago somewhere in the Superdome because we ain't live.
Nope.
But I think we're finna take a break. We're finna play another song by some artist who is performing at Essence Fest. You know what? I think right here I'm gonna play the new single from T-Ray the Violinist from his 90s R&B mixtape. This is Return of the Mac.
Return of the Mac, but
you lie to me. Okay.
Now imagine that, but with a violin.
Oh,
amazing.
Check it out right now, man. Stay tuned to the MisBelief Radio Show on WBOK. We'll be right back.
Don't get nothing on you.
Return of the Mac.
And that was Return of the Mac by T-Ray the Violinist. That's off his new 90s R&B mixtape. I'm going to look up the name of it real quick. But I mean, check out my frat brother T-Ray the Violinist. I did a little interview with him a couple days ago, so to speak. It was a pre-recorded interview. Mm-hmm. And he was busy, man. The dude getting his work. He's performing at the convention center tomorrow, probably during the gospel thing. So I called him for a little interview. And check out what T-Ray had to say real quick.
Okay. This is DC Paul. And I'm interviewing Trenton T-Ray Thomas, local violin player extraordinaire. And I'm sorry to call you local brother because I know recently, over the last few years, you've toured internationally. Am I right?
Yeah. I've been a couple places.
Like where?
Well, my first international hit was to London, London, United Kingdom, in 2015 with DJ Rockaway. Shout out DJ Rockaway.
What was the name of that project?
It was Progressive Existence. It was me and him, and we did what we called the Fish and Chips Tour, you know, because fish and chips is like a really big thing in Europe. So we did a GoFundMe, for that to raise money to cover our travel and lodging expenses. And we had about five, maybe six shows out there, and we picked up a couple open mic things while we were out there as well. So yeah, it was a cool experience. Yeah.
Dope. I would say 2015, maybe 2014 is around the time I was first introduced to you. But I've heard that you were, like, for a while, you went to UNO and people knew you back then before. But back when it was like T-Ray the Hip Hop Violinist, right?
Right.
You expanded your brand and growing up a minute. So how long have you been at it?
Well, I've been playing violin for about 17 years now. And what I do now, you know, I started out. This is back when I had MySpace, and that tells you how long ago this was. But, you know, I called myself T-Ray the Hip Hop Violinist because at the time, you know, even though I was at UNO and I was studying jazz, you know, I was still, I was experimenting with playing, you know, hip hop, and I was producing original songs that kind of had a hip hop nature to them. So that's when I kind of labeled myself as that. But then as I continued to grow and get involved with different types of music and explore different types of music, I was like, okay, I need to, you know, reevaluate, you know, how I'm labeling myself, because people can see that, you know, as, oh, he only does hip hop because he's the hip hop violinist. And, you know, I classify myself as a multi-genre violinist now.
Mm-hmm. There you go, man, because you just mentioned something I think is very important, branding, right?
Right.
You don't want to brand yourself as just a hip hop violinist, because after you expanded that brand, man, you've been all over the place since, right?
It's been a crazy 3 years. I've been a full time artist 3 years now. I was a full time teacher beforehand, after graduating from UNO, and it's been a wonderful 3 years. You know, it's had its ups and downs, but I wouldn't trade it for the world, man. It's a blessing.
I heard that. So this weekend is Essence Fest.
Yes.
You got a show at the Convention Center on Sunday, right?
Yes. I will be at the Convention Center 3:00 on the main stage in the Convention Center. So
nice. You playing by yourself? Any guests coming out there with you?
I only have like 10 minutes, so it just will be me running some stuff from my new mixtape, Essence of the '90s R&B Edition. So I'm actually dropping that project tonight.
I ain't heard of that one yet. How come I don't have it?
yeah, it's coming. I'm finishing up and it'll be out tonight. I'm gonna be doing a street performance tonight, tomorrow night, and then Sunday I'll be at Abstract Nola. So it's a jam packed weekend. Yeah.
Dope. Was it possible for me to get a copy of whatever song is your single from the mixtape so I can play here on this show?
Oh yeah, definitely. I'll make sure to get a copy to you, and we can figure out which song is getting the best reaction, I guess you could say. Because, I mean, the 90s were full of so many songs, you know, so it's hard to choose a favorite.
you covering or, like, reimagining 90s songs on this mixtape?
Yeah, so I have 10 tracks on there, and, you know, it's tracks from the 90s that I feel like, you know, in my opinion, were pivotal tracks. And what I did was I found the instrumentals for each of the songs. And basically what I've done in the past, I played the melody and took a solo on the songs. But this one, you know, I actually took a lot more time out to kind of, for lack of a better term, arrange string parts for the song so that it gives it a fuller and richer sound. Yeah.
Nice. All right, man. So after Essence Fest, what you got going on?
So I just dropped the new website. The new website is up and live, TRayTheViolinist.com. And after Essence Fest, I'm going to sleep on Monday. and then after that, I'm just working on the new project, Identity. I'm going to be working on that with producer Justin Williams, who's from here. He has placements with D1 and a few other artists in the industry. And then also collaborating with my band, Dreams to Reality, to create, you know, that the unique sound that I've been wanting to get out to the public, because it's, you know, you reach a point in your journey where it's like, okay, or I should say I've reached a point where, you know, I have to let my voice be heard. You know, covers, I've been saying it for long, covers are cool, covers get you noticed, but at the end of the day, you know, as an artist, you have to put yourself out there, you know, and I believe that, I believe that I've done enough things and put enough different sounds out that people are familiar with to be in a position to be able to put my own project out. So
I heard that, man. So Dream to Reality is your permanent band?
Yeah, so Dream to Reality is my band, and that came from me being a full-time teacher and then transitioning to being a full-time artist. So it's like, you know, I had to make a decision, okay, am I going to teach for the next 25 years, or am I going to, like, take that leap of faith and see about, you know, having a performance career as a violinist? And that's where that whole idea and concept came from, and I decided to adopt it as the band name as well.
Nice, man, nice. See, I'm a full-time artist as well. One thing we talk about a lot on this show is the fact that a lot of millennial artists operate on CPT. And that's
right,
not a
right.
black thing. That's creative people's time, right? Like, so what type of artist are you, man? Like, people know me, type of artist I am. I'm punctual. At least I try to be punctual. You know,
right.
I'm either early or on time.
Right.
No shame to you, brother. But what type of artist are you?
I would say I'm a very punctual artist as well. Okay. So yesterday, just to give you an example, I had sound check for the convention center, and I was told to be there for 12:15. So I, you know, planning ahead, I was there at like 11:45.
Mm-hmm.
And needless to say, the sound check didn't happen because of just logistics, so I have to go back in the morning. But yeah, anytime I have a gig, like, I make sure I'm there ahead of time, because you never know what can happen between the time you trying to get to the gig and getting there.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, you want to show your clients and you want to show the people you're working with that you respect their time and that you're really serious about what it is that you or the collective is doing.
Yes, indeed, man, because when you're working for somebody else, you got to be there on time. I know when I worked for other people, I was too punctual, you know, so when I started working for myself, I was like, man, I want to treat my boss, my new boss, better than any of the boss I've had before, right?
Right.
That's right, man. So you said your website is TRayTheViolinist.com. Is that T-Ray or just T-Ray, all one word?
Yeah, TRayTheViolinist, all one word. Yeah,
TRayTheViolinist.com. And what about the social networks? Where can we follow you at?
So on Instagram, it's T_RayTheViolinist. On Facebook, it's T_RayTheViolinist, so the dash in the middle between T and Ray. And then on Twitter, it's T_RayViolin.
All one word?
Yep, all one word.
Gotcha, man. Thank you so much for this quick interview, T-Ray, bro. I love you, brother.
No problem. Love you too, man. Appreciate it.
All right, man. This is T-Ray the Violinist. Y'all stay tuned. There's a MisBelief on WBOK. This is the Millennial or Simeo, and we'll be right back.
And that was T-Ray the Violinist. Catch him out there Sunday night. I'm sorry, Sunday during the day in the convention center doing his thing with his instrument.
Doing this thing with this instrument.
That sounded real inappropriate, but you know what I meant.
But people, shouts out to T-Ray the Violinist, because I got a mini story on that, man. I remember this girl, she's a friend of mine, and she was her son was getting into, she wanted to get him into the arts or whatnot, and she was mad because his son was interested in violin, but her husband thought that was like a girly instrument or whatnot. And she was like, man, like he likes it though, but he's interested, but like since his dad keep on pushing that on him, that, you know, da 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 da, I don't know what to do. So I sent her a video of T-Ray to be like, nah, man, that violin joint can be a beast if you play it right, you dig? So when she showed that to her husband or whatever, he started, you know, lightening up on it. So like, that's just how important, like, just all kind of representation is, yeah, man. Because they even see a black dude hitting it, getting it in with a violin, and then having the creative concepts and ideas like that one. Mm-hmm. I mean, the 90s joint, come on, son. So, yeah, like, big ups to him. Keep doing what you're doing, because you never know who you inspire.
Very innovative millennial. I believe he's from Baton Rouge, but he resides here.
We'll forgive that. We'll forgive
it's
that.
Sorry, right. He's from New Orleans.
Let's act like I didn't even say that. He's from New Orleans. All right.
He's from New Orleans.
Then we're going to take one more break, play one more song, and then when we come back, we're going to talk about what's going on out here, Essence Fest Edition. Listen, don't get nothing on you.
All right, tell us about your Essence Fest 2017 experience. What are you here doing for the festival? Are you hanging out? Are you eating? What's going on?
Wow, first, y'all want the truth or y'all want me just...
We want the truth. We want the whole truth.
Well, first of all, when I got here earlier for my sound check, security was being very extra. They've been really great since I first signed on to do it months ago. This has been a project that they have been working diligently on for months. So trust that it wasn't something that they just threw together. You could tell that they were very serious about it. I'm excited. Like, I'm here performing as an artist, but I am definitely wholeheartedly here as a fan. I'm like, if I see Diana Ross right now, I'm telling you, I'm dropping this mic and I'm running out this time. She's running out. Seriously, like, my mom will kill me if I'm in the same building as her and don't get a picture. Same thing for Mary, Jasmine. It's just so many women that are here. I love to see women in the same place and everybody's positive and everybody's working there about their business. And I don't know about any after parties. I got my husband here. So, you know, he be on something. Are we done? The work is done. Let's go back to the room. So I'm trying to maybe bribe him with some food. That's one of my things on this. I'm like, we're going to New Orleans? What do they have to eat there? Like, I'm a, you know, big girl. I like to eat. So that's my main thing. I just want to be a fan and see artists and I want to eat.
Right. I mean, like, you killed this last year. I mean, you came home and just literally murdered it. Woo! My personal question is, when can we expect a solo? You know, everybody's waiting on it, right? I know you get this all day, every day, this question. When can we expect that project?
It's cool. My solo album, 7 Winters and 6 Summers, it is coming the end of this year. I don't have an exact set date yet because we're not sure what date is coming out, but it's definitely coming this year. I'm working on it every day, very hard. A lot of people ask me, well, what is 7 Winters and 6 Summers, and, you know, how did you come up with that? Hey, how are you? I see him all the time. When I was incarcerated, I could not fathom counting the time in the years that they had given me. You know, I was given 8 years with 5 years post-release supervision, which was technically 13 years, and I just couldn't find myself counting like that. When I left, my son was 7 years old, so to count to 8 or 13 was just like crazy to me. So I would count based on what I saw out of my window. And out of my little window, either I would see green, because we was up in the woods, I would see green, which means it was summer, or it'd be bare trees, which meant it was winter. So if it was green outside and say it was like 2010, I'd be like, just 4 more summers, just 5 more summers to go. If it was bare and it was 2012, you know, I'd be 3 more winters. So ultimately, by the time I was released in 2014, I had did 7 winters and 6 summers. And I kind of just wanted to share my experience just through everything that I went through. A lot of people, you know, they say, well, you know, why would you want to talk about that? That's just like, you know, a really dark time in your life. But I went to prison when I was 26 years old. So if you count 7 years before that, I was still a teenager. So most of my adult life, I was in prison. And there's just a lot of things that I learned about life, about women, about myself, and I want to share that with the people via my solo album.
And we are back. Welcome back to the MisBelief Radio Show on WBOK AM 1230. This is DC Paul, the Millennial Arsenio, and real quick, we're going to go ahead and introduce our co-hosts who are in the booth at the moment. Who we got to my right side?
It's your boy, Alpha Joe, fresh out of the gumbo. You can find me on Fly With Bats Podcast, and you can find me on Facebook at Josef Alpha Man Pons.
Yep. And who is this to my left side?
This is Jay Steele, keeping it real. You can find me on Instagram at Jesso Steele or on Facebook at my full government, Jessica Elizabeth Johnson.
And who that is over there on her left side?
This is that actor guy, Martin Bass Bradford, find me at Mr. Bats on all your social media platforms. Spell it Mr. out, you dig? And what we getting into right now, Mr. Paul?
Man, this is one of my favorite segments, even though I say that about all of my segments because I love them all. But this is What's Going On Outchea.
What's going on outchea?
You hear me?
You hear me?
We talk about local talking points, news stories, topics, people, events, whatever's happening outchea that us as millennials are interested in. So, Josef.
Alpha Joe.
What's going on outchea, brother?
Well, what's going on outchea is that, how can I say
this? All right, you don't know. Okay.
It's just a little sad, you know? It's a little sad. Oh, well, I got some good news for some sad news. They caught all four of those guys who did that jacking during this SS Festival.
Yeah, man, good news. Because last week, I believe it was Oshun who talked about Crime Stoppers who increased their reward.
They increased it. I think it was like, about $1,000.
And I hated on it a little bit. I called it snitching. But in real life, man, if you know somebody who's out there doing that stupid stuff like those four young men who did that, man, ain't nothing wrong with either talking to them. And if you can't talk to them, turn them in.
One of the boys, mama said, I ain't bailing them out. I don't do that violence.
That's a real mama. Mm-hmm.
And I hope the jail, the system, you know, do them fairly, but I ain't bailing them out.
There you
That's
go.
That's real.
Man, I got it. What's going on out here, man. So just a few days ago, there was a high-speed chase. It started, I guess, on North Rampart near Canal Street, I believe continued to the interstate and ended in New Orleans East with a crash. So apparently...
the two-year-old that
got killed? Yeah, two people were ejected from the vehicle. That was the assailant. Well, no, the passenger and the two-year-old, and then the person driving the car apparently committed suicide as the police were approaching. So that happened out here.
Out here in my hood. In these Essence streets.
Yeah, man. Bats. you got something that'll wake it up? What's going on out here, man?
Man, shouts out to Cox Communications.
All right. I don't know if we want to
shout them out.
No, because I got Cox blocked yesterday.
I got Cox blocked. How the whole state of Louisiana got Cox blocked?
Right.
Oh. All at once.
All at once.
You know, I heard that they closed down for Essence, is what I heard.
No. I mean, it just sucked. They said a fiber, some fiber was cut and it knocked out all.
That's what you heard, huh?
Okay. I mean, that's what they claim.
Oh, conveniently.
A fiber was cutting, and when the black people come in our city, all of a sudden,
because we need all of our fibers. Okay.
We ain't got no internet. We ain't got no service. You got to be down with AT&T. Unless AT&T set that up. Because, you know, Cox, you know, AT&T, you know.
Shout out to Cox when they did rectify that in like a good 2-3 hours, something like that.
It was
right?
About 4-5, but they did rectify it. So, shouts out to Cox. But that was just an interesting little rift going on for Essence Fest weekend.
That was very inconvenient.
It's inconvenient as hell.
You can't Cox block a whole state.
No, not the whole state.
Come on now. Somebody
Cox got to get through.
Somebody.
What you got, Jay Still?
What's up, Jay Still?
So, on another Essence tip, speaking of Cox, maybe, you know, Mitch Landrieu, since he's taking down all these statues and whatnot, he could have fixed it. Maybe. No. Since he's everybody's superhero right now.
Whoa, sound like you got a Mitch Landrieu prop.
Apparently, Essence Fest thinks that he's some form of superhero because they gave him the most woke award.
They gave Mitch Landrieu the most woke award.
Yeah, I didn't know this was a thing. This just happened. This happened on Friday, yesterday.
See, I believe it's because, you know, he had that rousing speech during the...
That's absolutely what it was.
Yeah.
Because
they say that's his bid for trying to be president at some point, to try to go for that, you know, in the future. And, like, that's one of those speeches that you look back on and be like, oh, this is one of those that set the tone for, oh, he can touch people. His words can stand the test of time. He can make a difference, et cetera, et cetera.
Et cetera.
But taking down Nola don't think the same way. What you saying, man?
Mitch Landrieu, you know what I'm saying? Listen, all shouts out to take him down Nola. Of course, they're, you know, the true engine and the fuel that pushed everything for this to happen. But this man did has a part to play in it as well. And, you know, just like his father, he took a right step in the right lane of history. And, you know, whether it be on one side of the coin, it's still as good on the other. So and all of that, I heard he got some Native American man black in him. So,
I heard a couple of things about the Landrieu family about that.
I give him the Walker Award. He bald headed with no negativity.
Right, no bald-head negativity. But you know what? The most woke, though?
That's my issue. Like,
I mean, just because you...
The thing about it's an honorary award, so okay, I guess they're just trying to... You know, they're showing them some love. He's a mayor of New Orleans. They come in here. It happened at the Essence Empowerment stage, so...
And he's going to support Essence.
And honestly, shout out to Essence for coming to the city and, like, I guess, acknowledging...
It's politics on politics. That's what it feels like. It's like they're being political with our political figure. But me, you were talking about this at Essence about how, like, the term woke is, like, dead once it starts getting commercial commercialized in this manner.
It loses its meaning, right?
Oh, we shouldn't go in like this. I'm gonna leave it alone. Waiting, we're like, yeah, but I'm gonna say my real straight up.
Go ahead, go
man. Look, tongue, straight man. Up. Now, if you're gonna use, I'm not even gonna just pick on Essence. I'm saying, generally speaking, once any word gets into the atmosphere that used to be counterculture, but now it's the mainstream, it's not what it used to be. So once we start talking about, oh, we gonna give our mayor the wokest woke award, when woke used to mean something, or meant something for black people, right, waking black people right up to see the screwed up things that's going on, and then we gonna give the first wokest award to this white dude who got a questionable history at times in this city.
Exactly.
Even though, thank you, much respect for the things that he eventually did do to take down them, you know, them statues. You know, I can understand why some people might have an issue, but I can also understand why some people's like, you know what, he held us down when we needed to. And look, any positive representation for the city is a great representation for the city, because too many times they just think we some heathens and ignorant down here. So if you're right, gonna stand up and be the mayor of the city and say that real and get recognized by everybody to say, oh, that the mayor of New Orleans, man, he on to something, I'll take that.
What I love about New Orleans, the blackness in the water. Like, I love coming here and feeling the water in the air. I like that. And I like the way people, I like that New Orleans accent. And I don't eat a lot of meat and stuff, so I don't come here and like eat the food, like that's not my thing. But just like the way the air feels and, you know, hearing people's accents all the time. I got to sing for the mayor's ball yesterday. He was just like, you are a queen. He did. He said, you're like a real queen. And I was like, thank you. And he said, cause I sang this song called One for him. And he said, did you write that? I said, I did write that. He said, that's incredible. It's incredible. I was like, the mayor is really talking like this right now.
Yeah, it gives New Orleans some good shine, some good positive shine outside of the typical stories that you might.
But y'all ain't gonna make me bite my tongue.
Because you know, Essence has been good to us.
You right.
I got this thing called, they're using one of these hashtags, hashtag Woke Wonderland, and it just gave out a woke award.
That. Don't they have an app or something?
Is that Woke Wonderland app?
There is, yes. Wow. There is. If you go on Essence.com and click on the festival link, there is a little tab where you can create, like, take a selfie, and then you can put all this stuff on, all these pictures, and post Hashtag Woke Wonderland.
Okay, so they got the Woke Wonderland, and they're giving out the most woke award, but just know that the word woke was deaded way before, you know, Essence. But I mean,
because
you know,
Nick, people
might as well jump
people started
on it.
overusing it. The overusage of woke might as well just get a neck right quick.
Yeah.
Just
quick neck.
Just overusage.
Andrew is black. All right.
He said
he's
it.
Afternoon, my octa room. Right? So y'all gonna let this man get this woke award?
Man, get him as well. I mean, he got it. He good. He doing what he doing. Right. And just no disrespect to Essence, dog. Like you said earlier, dog, I love the fact that they bring so much to the black community just by coming here, and so much, and it's such positive experiences. So many beautiful women.
So many beautiful women.
Yeah, man.
Beautiful, successful, affluent black women.
Say that again. Say that again, Jay. Still
beautiful.
Beautiful, successful, affluent, successful.
Affluent.
Oh my God, yes.
Fine.
Yes.
Like, what?
Yo, you're talking about me. You know what I'm saying? Yo, I sure am.
Give me
I sure am.
All year long.
Yo, so yeah, shouts out to Essence, man, you know.
Shouts out to Essence, man. So, Josef Alpha Man Pons, what else is going on out here?
Oh, man, what's going on out here is that I follow this lady named Silver LaFox, and she's out here taking pictures with Roland Martin. Roland Martin is in the city. And that's what's going on out here, is that he's out there on Bourbon Street taking pictures with the lady Silver Fox, who's out there with her music, dancing half naked.
Oh, her. Okay, I know her. Yeah, well, you know what? Ain't no surprise Roland Martin is out here, man. Everybody's here. Jada Pinkett, Queen Latifah, the whole cast of Girl Trip is out here.
Farnsworth Bentley.
Farnsworth, we saw Farnsworth
Bentley. Wait.
You walked right past
And it seemed like we might have had better seats than him. I was about to say
I haven't heard that name in a few years.
Right. Martin was like, that's old dude that used to be with Diddy.
Yeah, I couldn't even get his name, but who made it?
Who, Lil C?
He does that mean?
Oh, Pons word.
Loon? Was it right. Loon?
Went down on the whole list of names, man. Craig Mack. You know, so what is Craig Mack?
Okay.
We went down the whole list. I was like, man, I went through all the members of making the band. I was like, who? Dylan? Who?
Dylan?
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 What was it? Dylan?
Was it day 26?
It was day 26.
The whole day 26.
It was Fonzie Bentley. He was up in one of the.
It's what doing bad boy this, bad boy back, bad boy get you down with a baseball bat.
Yeah, he was up in one of the high sections, man. You know what? What is going on out here for Essence Fest? It's a good one, man. Shout out to my man, Sherby. The comedian Carter,
mm-hmm.
He was on our show a few weeks ago.
What is?
He had the whole Superdome smelling like his nuts.
His nuts, yeah.
As soon as he walked in the Superdome, he smelled Sherby's nuts mm-hmm. all through that thing, and it was just
we appreciated the smell of his nuts.
It's so
throughout
good
the entire,
to see like a black man like and his nuts just smell so good, and like everybody in the Superdome was like, "What smells so good?"
That's
Sherby's nuts.
Yeah.
Right. So shout out to Sherby, man.
We appreciate it.
His nuts are amazing.
His nuts are amazing, man.
Can't lie, bro.
So sweet.
Thank you, sir.
So sweet. Perfectly roasted.
Yeah.
You know?
So, something else that was going on out here, this happened a little while ago. I want to say shouts out to Representative Cedric Richmond, who, like, that dude Steve King, one of those racist Republican cats,
yes.
Was trying to liken us to some third world country or whatever.
Guatemala.
And, like,
what?
Boy, Cedric Richmond said, boy, you will not be saying this. Mm-hmm. Like, he went in on him and basically said, we could take it outside.
He even said, if I have to come over there, something like, if I have to come over there, I will. Now, he kept it very respectful for the session, because they was in the session.
Yes.
But, like, He kept it all the way real as he could and still kept his job. Like,
yeah.
Is Cedric from the
Nine? He came like he was from the Nine. And he ain't mind
from
dying, you feel
nine.
Me?
No, maybe come over there.
He did, because Steve King, Representative Steve King, he was trying to say that the deaths in
El Salvador.
And whatnot was likened to the post-Katrina deaths in New Orleans.
Oh, man.
And once again, this is a constant problem where they try to, you know, compare black, especially urban cities or black cities and minority cities to, like, they do it to Chicago all the time.
Right.
You know what I mean? To these areas across the world and say, see, they're basically trying to say people of color have a problem with violence.
And shout out to Cedric Richmond for not allowing those racial undertones to go mm-hmm. unchecked. You
right.
Because, I mean,
if they needed to be checked.
If you listening, you know exactly what this man was saying, and that's inappropriate. So, yeah, Cedric, go over there and talk to the man.
You hear me? He said, we just had a conversation about this. We're going to lose all civility in this committee if he thinks it's appropriate to compare New Orleans to Guatemala. You're comparing the people in the locations. That would be like me comparing him to somebody in the Klan. I don't have a basis to do that.
Man,
I wear badges of bipartisanship because I actually take up and stand for the principles. I'm not going to sit here and let him do that now to the people I love, the people I respect, and I live in New Orleans. Now, if the gentleman persists on it, then let's go in the back mm-hmm. and have a conversation
he
about
said,
New
let's
Orleans.
Go in the back.
You hear me? We'll
talk about it somewhere else.
So shouts out, man. I just had to, you know, that happened a few days ago. By to be like, nah, that has to be said. He has to be commended. Big ups to the black man.
Boy with a Kennedy.
Oh,
you
enough
that
said.
Up?
I'm making that up.
All
right.
Because he's just getting real. He's
right.
That boy with the John Mack. You heard me? Straight
that's
up,
what's up, man. That's what's going on out here. Just so still.
Yeah.
I know that's not the name you go by on the radio.
No, it's not.
That's Instagram.
It's just the Instagram name.
Yeah,
I'm sorry,
Instagram.
But you got so many aliases. Jay Still. I like Jessica Rabbit.
Yeah, I don't tell too many people about that one.
That was the person.
You said it on the radio. Was I mean, it's fitting. I know we ain't doing Facebook Live, but if they can see you, it's a fitting name.
Uh-huh.
But what else is going on out here?
Well, speaking of Essence again, this is kind of related to Essence, but not really. But I'm going to make it work anyway. And y'all going to be like, ooh, that's what's up.
Wild me.
So, you know, if you're down here for Essence, there's a lot of different things you could do. There's, you know, the zoo, there's clubs, there's all this kind of stuff. Speaking of the zoo recently, one of the giraffes died.
What?
Out of nowhere. Yeah.
Giraffe, ain't nobody called me and told me
the
nothing.
The giraffe died.
What happened?
Bruh.
And I'm trying to figure out what's going on at the zoo because they done had two lions die.
So, tiger died. So it's an epidemic.
And now the giraffe, you know, all the little kids watching, oh, look at the giraffe. And the giraffe
and
died. Dropped dead.
So,
on site.
So the giraffe died, the two lions died, and all of a sudden there's a new Winn-Dixie. On Chef Mentor.
I think it's a conspiracy.
All this extra meat.
And
that
chicken ain't really
like,
chicken.
And you know, giraffes are pretty big and sexy, so I could see how
you just say giraffes are sexy.
Man, look how big them booties are, man. Giraffes got some big old booties.
Big
and sexy with long necks.
That sounds like something I would normally say,
I'm not canceling claiming, no. Jamie Foxx said it on one of his specials once. And I was like, oh, yeah, I agree. So I'm going with you, Jamie. I'm riding this. And I'm not throwing away. No, forget Jamie Foxx, though, because in his new movie, Baby Driver, guess what his character is?
What?
Bats. The name of his character is Bats.
Oh, that's
movie.
Just disrespectful. Oh, wow. I think you need to so
forget Jamie Foxx. I don't know how I segued into that, but
Jamie
Foxx, man.
I still like you, dog. I'm gonna do a song with you. Man. If you hear this, Alpha Joe saying
traitors.
No loyalty whatsoever.
I'm sorry to hear that, Bats, man. We've been branding that actor guy Bats.
Forever, and now he gonna in this movie. And if Bats? His movie does what? Good, they gonna be like, oh, so you call yourself Bats because Jamie Foxx?
Because the Baby Driver.
That's
a dumb name, by the way.
I don't think no one's gonna be baby saying driver. That.
But Bats, your IMDb don't it have Bats on it?
Yes,
already?
It does.
Okay, so then, and that's been up longer than this movie.
I am Martin Bats Bradford.
There's your claim.
That actor. Guy.
Take that one. So we got any more? What's going on out here?
Well, in sports news. Because boy, Alpha Joe loves sports. They just signed your boy Giroux to a $126 million deal, which is one of the highest in the point for the point guard.
They as in the Pelicans.
New Orleans Pelicans. They them people.
The people.
They
sure did.
But that's really good. I like him as a point guard. He's pretty good. I mean, honestly, I think we need a couple of more people to come in. But we got your boy DeMarcus Cousins. So this season is looking pretty good for the Pelicans. We've signed deals all over. We got a little money to spend. All right, Tom.
that pause of air of no one saying anything after he spoke was all of us not being sports fans having nothing
being like
to say.
Word, that's yeah. What's up. Well, cool,
but
awesome.
his excitement was very inspiring.
Yeah,
I feel you.
And they, we have a lot of listeners that do, you know, are in the sports.
Yeah, house, you know what, Alfred? I think I'm gonna start making, like, if I can weekly, I'm gonna let you give a little what's going on out here sports segment. Quick.
Oh yeah, I do a quick one.
Nice, okay, I appreciate that, man.
I feel like I have a feeling that him and Madani could probably talk about
sports.
Oh,
probably, sports. Yeah.
Madani looks like sports.
He
looks like all the sports.
The shame.
Madani got elbow muscles. I ain't seen anybody with an elbow muscle. Like, how you got a muscle in your elbows, huh? On your forehead,
Oh, man, strong. Your house doesn't have the bell. Ding.
I know. I think that's pretty much all for what's going on.
Yeah, man, that's all I got right now, man. All right,
we're going to go ahead and take one more break. And we're going to play something from somebody.
Somebody dealing with something that's dealing with New Orleans.
But look, the most important thing is, don't get nothing on you. We'll be right back. She makes perfectly flawed eyewear. Locals, you hear me?
Love the locals.
She's supposed to be on the MisBelief radio show 2 times. She canceled on us.
No, I'm coming.
Perfectly flawed eyewear. Follow her.
I'm coming.
Follow her on Instagram. This is Timmy from Stick Together Brand, if you ain't heard me the first time.
I know, he said it.
Shawn Perrier, one of the best singers in the city.
My brother, he's the best at everything he does.
Who you about to say, fuck?
Trombone Shorty.
Yeah, man.
Born and raised in Jamaica, baby.
Kevin, Miss Belief, watches, Miss Richie Lee. She helps to run things at the big community theater. You probably can't hear me out.
Probably not. Yeah. But we'll try to make it work.
All day. All day. All day. Yes, me.
What's up, baby?
Give me a hug. Hi, y'all. Hello, I'm Derry.
Nice to meet you. You're beautiful.
Derry, how long you in town?
Until next Friday. How long?
Oh, man. This is for the MisBelief Radio Show podcast for our YouTube.
Oh.
This is Derry after Tucker, just coming back from China, right?
No, I was in South Korea.
Oh, you moved.
I don't know how it was.
It was amazing. I actually was a musical called Dream Girls, and I was understudy for Michelle. We were older than 4 months, and we did 94 shows. It was a lot of work, but it was such a blessing, and I'm glad to be back home, safe and sound. My people are doing their success.
This is South Korea.
give back to New Orleans once again. Support local artists. We're going around.
So proud of you.
Hi, y'all. We are back. As you can tell, it's pretty quiet in here.
It's quiet. It's all, that testosterone, all that male energy.
I know. It's out of here. It's me, the one and only Oshun, and
Jay Still, keeping it real.
Yeah, Jay Still. So we are actually sitting here without the guys, mm-hmm. which never, ever happens. It never happens. They are completely out
it's
of the
rare,
room.
It's rare, completely. Like, right.
They actually gave us the microphone.
They so in trouble now.
I know. I don't know what should we do. I think we should talk about all the women business that's going on for Essence.
We should, but hold up. I want to talk about Big Freedia.
Because
apparently Big Freedia did an appearance and did like an interview at Essence Fest. I think Friday.
Friday?
Mm-hmm.
And how did that go?
I think it went pretty well, but a big part of it was they were really talking about Freedia as a style icon.
Which is true.
Because Freedia's known for, like, you know, music, bounce music. If you're from New Orleans, Big Freedia is probably one of the most classic original bounce music artists. But what was interesting to me was they were really focusing on Freedia's style, from the hair to the outfits to the makeup to everything. And it's really interesting.
And if you look at it, and if you look at Big Freedia and her style, that is classic uptown girl fashion. Mm-hmm. That's what I feel. I feel like it's classic New Orleans runaway girl look.
Right. And apparently, for a long time, her mom was the one that was styling.
Oh, yeah.
Her mom is her biggest supporter. And right. That's amazing.
And she's actually keeping it going. Big Freedia, if you ever see Big Freedia in person, she's very personable. Mm-hmm. Like, if you walk up and be like, hey girl, how you doing? Mm-hmm. It's always a, hey, baby. It's never anything other than that. And
right. You
I can
don't
respect
get any
that.
Forms of uptight or any forms of anything, man. But I definitely would say Freedia's style is like a combination of, like, mm-hmm. RuPaul mixed with, like, Beyonce, mixed with, like, a little Michael Jackson, maybe. It's just a lot.
You know what's
a lot going on?
It's a good explanation.
It's a good thing,
it's right. a good explanation. You know who else I've seen around this city? Mr. Queen Sugar himself, Coffee, also Coffee. Known as Ralph Angel.
Mr. Siri Bo. They call him Siri Bay.
Oh my God. Mm-hmm. He is.
Women are losing their minds over him. He's been everywhere. I don't think he can go anywhere now.
He's a
without.
Mystical creature.
Yeah.
He likes pops up.
Mm-hmm.
And he's always with his shirt unbuttoned. That's why I always
The shirt is always unbuttoned. The skin is oiled. The teeth are white.
White in perfection.
I've heard that he levitates.
Yes.
His feet don't touch the ground.
Like Prince. You know how Prince used to float?
Yes. Oh,
Prince used to float into a room. That's how I feel like when he
walked
into a room.
Wait, I have a Prince story.
What? Give me your Prince story.
I have a Prince story. Oh my gosh. So, this is the first year I have not worked for Essence. Typically, I do production work for Essence.
Okay.
And it was funny to me one year because he was performing. It was actually the year before he died.
Mm.
He performed at Essence. And so I was doing production, you know, I was running a couple of things in the super lounges. I got done with what I was doing, went down to go see him perform.
Mm-hmm.
I kid you not. And I'm around all the different people, stage managers, everybody coordinate. This man appeared on stage.
Just like out of nowhere.
He appeared on stage and we were all confused. Mind you, like, I'm a part of this and I'm like, where did he come from? We were just like, oh, he literally had probably like a small group of people that were responsible for getting him on stage, and everybody else is out the loop. He appears when he appears.
That's amazing.
He's magic.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So you say you used to work for Essence. You did production. So all behind mm-hmm. the scene work, that's all you.
Yeah.
Can I tell you my favorite Essence story? One year, my family was on Family Feud Essence.
Oh, my goodness.
Horrible. We did horrible. Steve Harvey was like, now this family over here was another family on that side. And he was like, that family over there, they look like they related. But this family over here, I feel like it's going to be something.
He's so shady.
It's going to be something. He was right, though.
Mm.
Because we wasn't all related. It was definitely me, my aunt, my cousin, my best friend, mm-hmm. who I told to pretend like she was my cousin.
Y'all had a little gumbo going on. It y'all was just, that. We going to make it work for
it
this
show. It
was just,
everything was just mm-hmm. all over the place. But they need to bring that back because I want to go back on there.
They should bring that back. But there's going to be a lot of good things going on even today. This is Saturday. Speaking of Queen Sugar and Kofi, they are going to be appearing today at the convention center a couple of times to push the second season that's on right now.
That show does not need any pushing. It's amazing.
It does not need anything.
It's an amazing show.
Right.
And I feel like New Orleans right now for filming, acting, like,
it's,
all of
it's
that.
It's getting back where it needs to be.
Right.
For sure.
Like, we are becoming, well, not becoming, because we were already there, but we are going back to the roots of entertainment that we were, I want to say, when we had all the great jazz, mm-hmm. and they had that,
mm-hmm.
that burst of energy come through the city.
Right.
I feel like that was a great time.
It definitely was a great time. But interestingly enough, apparently New Orleans is still number one for
I know,
projects, even over Georgia. Right. So.
What y'all in here talking about?
Oh, the men are back.
Hey.
This is the MisBelief Misses. It's the one and only Oshun.
And this is the real J Still, keeping it real.
We miss so India Max. She needs to come back.
Oh.
Yeah, and keep it black.
And keep it black. Misses. Right.
Yes.
See? All
right, that's cool.
They hating.
We hating.
Y'all definitely hating.
We'll go to break, though. We about to say some more Little Limit. What we playing?
Probably you know what? Since Snoop was a part of No Limit at one point, right?
And little known fact.
He's also in town.
Yeah.
Let's play something from Snoop's No Limit era.
So, something touch the mother hitters.
Yeah.
One hitters, them hitters. We getting them. We got them. Snoop was so cool on that, so everybody like, yeah, yeah, yeah. And Snoop like, yeah.
Right. So California.
Yes, indeed, man. So we're going to play that in a couple more songs, and we'll be right back. Stay tuned to the MisBelief Radio Show.
Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips. What? Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips. What? Touch the mother hips, I ride for my hips. I die for my hips, man. Touch the mother hips, what? Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips. What? Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips. What? Touch the mother hips, I ride for my hips. I die for my hips, man. Touch the mother hips, man. I'm down with no limit. I ride for the cause. I'm the soldier on the tank with the big, big balls. And if anybody messes with Snoop Doggy Dog, I'ma make his people put his name on the wall. And everywhere I go, I got Mr. Magic Jeff. Because I know that boy don't care. He'll have that red stuff pouring out your hair. Clear any given time, clear anywhere. Make him bleed is the motto that I live by. If you mess with me, it's a must you die. Them haters might go run, but them haters can't hide. It's like shooting yourself, it's a suicide. Exhale, got the beat hitting hard like Dirt Boys. And I know you know I'm as Big Hurt. Just like Soldier Slim, he'll put you in the dirt and have your picture on front of a t-shirt. And when I make moves, I got 100 soldiers with me, just in case the haters out there trying to hit me. All my players is down to squeeze the trigger. That's why I'm down for my no limit killer. Touch the money, cause I'm down for my hips. What? Touch the money, cause I'm down for my hips. What? Touch the mother hitters, I ride for my hitters, I die for my hitters, man. Touch the mother hitters, what? Touch the mother hitters, cause I'm down for my hitters, what? Touch the mother hitters, cause I'm down for my hitters, what? Touch the mother hitters, I ride for my hitters, I die for my hitters, man. Touch the mother hitters,
what? You ain't heard, boy, I ride with my knockers. Die with my knockers. Just drive by my 45 cause I'm down with my knockers. Snoop Dogg and Boss Felini. Don't shoot now, victim, just call me when you need me. Leave me, I never bite the hand that feed me. Just point the clowns out and I leave them all in the street bleed. Boy, you messing with a grown man. Have it and wag you in your house and then buried you on your own land. See the cops, they scared to come and get me. But I don't blame them cause they know I got a bunch of thug figures with me. Looking for trouble starting it. I'm riding solo when I'm busting and getting rid of your clique. See, you boys ain't about beef, eh? But you messing with brothers that'll definitely get you eternal sleep. But if you didn't get the picture, boy, I ride with my
What hitters? Them hitters? Yeah, dog, you with it. Touch them, let's get them. Do them, I did them. We getting nutty in this mother.
What?
I got my buddy in this mother.
What?
Leave a sucker bloody in this mother.
What?
We in the cutting mother. You done too much, you got it coming mother.
Watch
out. Some of these suckers is chickens too. And some of these suckers look just like you. Well, where I'm from we like to ride on fours. We do it from the shoulders, so do it from the toes. I do my dirt off on my lonely. See murder and magic? Hell yeah, them my no limit homies. So when the leg gets thick and foggy, and you suckers wanna act like y'all wanna get with Snoop Dogg, let me let you haters know.
Let them know, dog.
Bump what you going through and bump what you stand for.
Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips.
What?
Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips.
What?
Touch the mother hips, I ride for my hips. I die for my hips, man. Touch the mother hips.
What?
Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips.
What?
Touch the mother hips, has them down for my hips.
What?
Touch the mother hips, I ride for my hips. I die for my hips.
And we We are back. We are back. Welcome back to the MisBelief Radio Show on WBOK AM 1230 Essence Fest Edition. This is, like I always say, one of my favorite segments on the MisBelief Radio Show, where I get to let my homie MisterBats go unbridled, unrestrained. He's gonna slap somebody on the back of the neck, and they're gonna feel it all the way on the West Bank. All right, Bats, who you giving neck to tonight?
All right, so this is kind of like, sort of like the first time I done it live in a minute, but we ain't really live. We pre-recorded. What? It's a live-ish episode, live-ish, right? So live-ish. So we getting that live-ish neck, you kinda dig? Like, so, you know, I'm looking around. You know, we looking at the Essence Fest thing. I just want to put y'all in a... I'm gonna put y'all, you know, in a position, man. Okay, imagine there's a big event is coming. Let's say you the mayor, you own a city or whatever, an event is coming that you know gonna bring in buku money. You know the more people that's spending money is the more that you can do for the community, that you can do for the roads, that you can do for what the hell did you do with your money, you feel me? So what you think you would want your businesses to do? Would you want your businesses to stay open so all that money could come around, whether through taxes and just keep building and building and building, you could actually do some stuff with it? Or would you be happy where businesses are closing when a bunch of people about to come and spend money, especially businesses that deal with hospitality and restaurants and such, that mainly that tourists that'll be coming into your city will be spending and spending and spending, because this event, which brings in thousands, is designed to do just that, make your city money. Now, I don't have to ask you, that was a completely rhetorical question, and since we're on the radio, you can't answer it anyway, and we don't accept calls on live-ish episodes. So lady on the West Bank that was coming at DC, we could talk about your West Bank self, but you can't do nothing till next week. You heard me? But the mofos, the mud pluckers that we giving neck to today are all you businesses, and this has been going on for years and years and years. Shouts out to Malik Bartholomew, man. I was looking at an article from just last year where they quoted him talking about how fishy it is that you would be an establishment in the French Quarter area and decide to close your doors down when the black event comes into town. You dig? I don't see that happening when all these other events happen. I don't ever see that happen aside from when the black event comes. You dig? So if you're gonna be that goofy about it, if you're gonna be that obvious with it, if you're gonna be the Trump's American supporters like that and not even accept black people's money, even though black people made this city what it is. I mean, what's that t-shirt that Pet shouts out to Sonny D and Petty Mayonnaise at the Triliteric podcast? But what that shirt say?
Everything that you love about the world is because of black people.
Everything that you love about America is because of black people. How about we go there, you feel me? So to all you businesses for Essence Fest, decide to shut your doors on all my beautiful, beautiful, gorgeous, intelligent, successful, persevering, and all the adjectives you want throw in that gumbo pot. Y'all join me together to give them that mighty, mighty...
And we ain't never all collectively gave somebody a neck, but y'all deserve it, man. You stupid for losing out on this Essence Fest money because you want to be subtly racist.
Yeah, man.
You know what? It's time to go on a break real quick. When we come back, we're going to do a Sankofa session, and then we're getting out of here.
We're going
to
get about shit, man.
Drop the knowledge on us for YouTube.
The god of power, creativity, venturemaker, PTAH, Hollywood stove, and turn into Oscar.
Download that WBOK 1230 app.
Uh-huh.
You feel me? And go check us out right now because we're going 7 to 9 like usual. We got some good stuff for you to recap what we've been doing for Essence.
Yeah.
WBOK 1230 app. Check it out. Check
Also, our episode is playing right now on the website. That's www.wbok1230am.com. Check us out. Oh, that's Gus. That's Gus Bennett. That is the Gus Bennett. The Gus Bennett. Oh, my goodness.
This is my first FaceTime live.
Oh, I didn't ask permission for that.
No, go for it. I'm good.
Okay, you good.
But y'all too, I'm good.
Nice, man. Thank you.
I'm normally behind the cameras, man.
Yeah, man. You
know, good to see everybody. Thank you for the love, everybody.
What up, man? Who that is? Z Tory Taylor.
What'd your shirt say? Let me see.
Oh, what? Yeah, clearly. If you ain't already know, read the shirt. That's the truth.
Straight up.
Man. Whoa. Who's that? Meryl Burkett?
Yeah.
I'm banging the bangers. All y'all here?
I don't know.
You're by yourself?
Yeah. I'm
okay, that's what's up, man. Taking a break. So when you leave the city, when you go back on tour?
I think on the 9th, going to Pittsburgh.
Oh, y'all here for a few days then? Don't tell me that y'all doing shows? All right, you know on Wednesday where to be at though, the jazz market. All right, just in case you feel like it.
We're gonna be in there.
Nice, man.
So we in the smoking section. We run into
Brother Razor. Man, gospel, positive Christian rapper, bro. He's so dope. Every time he came to the Tank of the Bangers backyard and hang out, he killed it, man. And we play his song on the MisBelief radio show.
Yeah.
He shouts out to MisBelief in one of his songs, man.
Look, I never thought that I'd be right where God got me. Was thugging up in the streets. Not God got me. I first surrendered in heat. Washed my sins away. No one wanted to believe. They say it was a phase. Went hard 2 years straight. Then I strayed away. Wasn't going up in the temple. But I stirred and prayed. Backslid. Popping them pills. Blowing green again. Lord, please forgive me. I'm on my knees again. Took my eyes off you. The worst thing I can do. Stripped everything from me. Even my girl too. Had to rededicate my life. Now I'm getting it right to use me as a vessel so I can shine my light, and I'ma clean up what I messed up and start my life all over again. He washed my sins up and I'm blessed up. My eyes on the promise, yeah, I'm ready to win. I was a selfish somebody, had to get it popping. But Lord brought me down and brought me down to rock bottom. He let me know I had a plan for me and I got a purpose. Everybody can come with me, I gotta drop him. I was a selfish somebody, thought I had it popping, yeah. But God got me right and brought me down to rock bottom. Yeah. He let me know I'm a plan and I got a purpose. Everybody don't come for me, I gotta drop them. See where he got me at, where I need to be at, teaching me discipline. Couldn't save a stack, quick to waste a hundred, spending too much money. Priorities all messed up, like things sweet like honey. I'm a good dad to my daughters, but I gotta be better. So I'm pressing and pressing, I gotta get it together. I'm a workaholic, but consistent is the key. Couldn't stay on one job, was quick to quit in the week. I had to stop it and look at my situation and buckle down and take care of business, baby, cause God for me. But can't use him as a spare tie and give him praise, honor, and glory at all times. He told me that I'm a king, time to get my crown. But first, there's some people I gotta let go that be around. I'm sensitive to his voice, so I hear when you speak. He tell me it's a process, so keep your eyes on me. I was a selfish somebody, thought I had it popping. But God got me right and brought me down to rock bottom. He let me know he had a plan for me and I got a purpose. Everybody can come with me, I gotta drop him. I was a selfish somebody, thought I had it popping. But God brought me down to rock bottom. He let me know he had a plan for me and I got a purpose. Everybody can come with me, I gotta drop them. See, when I first surrendered, I told you to come in my heart and make me a winner. Now I'm full of the spirit, I got full control. The devil tripping and attacking cause he missed the soul. Old things passed away, I'm a new creature. Got baptized, you could even see my new features. Thought I was good, I was headed to the pits of hell. Acting like a peasant, but I'm royalty like the Prince of Wales. He took me out of deep, so a hole so deep, I can't thank him enough. If I had 1,000 tongues, I couldn't thank him enough. I messed up, but it's all good, cause I'm the freestyle genius. And they know everything that I speak, yeah, I mean it. Used to be rapping for the devil, now I rap for the Lord. I go, oh, you can see me in the backyard hangout, getting that MisBelief punch and cutting up with T-Tina. You know how I go down,
yeah. That's Brother Razor, you heard me from the night one.
And tell us about that video you got.
Look, the mixtape about to drop next week, Time to Get Right. My first gospel CD. I'm a gangster, ex-gangster rapper, been rapping since I was 5 years old, you know what I'm saying? God touched me, let me know he had a plan for me. Now I'm rapping for the Lord. I'm a gangster for Christ, Brother Razor. Y'all remember that?
Brother Razor.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yes.
I love when I go live and stuff like that happens. Shout out to Brother Razor.
Shout out
to Tank of the Bangers, yeah. T-Tina, and the whole Bangerville, man.
Yeah.
Going back inside. I appreciate you, Brother
Razor. Shout out.
Man, make sure y'all come in. I'm going to come on the show.
Shout out to Brother Razor, who just stepped on the stage, rapped about all God, and how his life then got saved. Now he's up on his place, selling nuts for your boss. Smurf.
Shout out to Shervy, man. Shervy and Goat Nuts. They all over the Superdome, man. The whole Superdome smell like Shervy nuts.
And they smell so good.
I ain't never smelled nuts smell that good, Shervy.
Man. Nuts in my bag, nuts in my hand. Get your almonds, cashews, pecans, cinnamon glaze. Guaranteed to put a smile on your face.
Yeah.
Catch up with y'all, man.
Dope, man. Dope, bro. Man. Come to Essence Fest. Just come to Essence Fest next year. It's the last night right now, but next year, make it a plan to come to Essence Fest. Yeah, Rel. Yeah, Sherelle. She said no, huh? Yes, indeed, man. Brother Razor did that.
Yeah, huh? Brother
Razor right there just killed it. Rapping for the Lord. Doing God's work.
Oh, I love this city, man.
About to catch up with the homie Chris Robb and Jay Steele, who was on the stage.
Oh, yeah, man. Jay Steele from the MisBelief. She was on stage with Solange. Christopher Robinson, my homie, was on stage, man.
Double Monster, Chris Robb in the building. We all over the place.
All over the place. Cut it off now. We'll see y'all in a minute. Sunbone Shorty on stage. All right, y'all, we like to end every episode of the MisBelief Radio Show with a look back at another time, another place, another person, somebody, something that came before us and made us the magical millennials that we are today. So, Oshun, who are we taking a look back at this week?
I usually give a brief summary of a person for Sankofa, but today I want to give an idea of something that I think will be effective to change who we are as people. Our ancestors laid a great foundation for us to change the world.
Mm-hmm.
We have to pick up that baton and lead with it. The generation that's coming after us is a little bit peculiar, just as I feel though they thought that we were. But here's my thing. An idea for greatness that can change the world is for all of the people of color out there who can hear my voice. This is an idea for us to glow and grow together. Why don't we take the time, as far as Essence Fest goes this weekend, and get to know somebody that we don't know, whether they be from a different state, maybe even from a different country. Who knows who you might meet? And spread your brand or a brand or an idea of someone else so we can fellowship and love on each other. They have times where, especially this time of year, where a lot of businesses in our city close and they, you know, random repairs, quote unquote, this, that, and the third.
Maybe being whole hose pipes out here.
Right. So why don't we support and flourish our own brands, our own ideas, our own people, make things better for us? We can actually change the world. So that is my Sankofa today, people. Catch me out here in these streets today and tomorrow. I love y'all and be safe.
All right, y'all. That was our Sankofa session. But my baby Oshun, how dare she call somebody peculiar? She's the most peculiar person I know.
I am a weirdo.
But thank you so much. I love you, and I couldn't do this without you. Without you. Anyway, y'all, this has been an interesting episode of the MisBelief Radio Show. Join us right here, same time, same place. You know what? Let me one more go around for all of my fabulous co-hosts. So I'm swinging my thing across the table, and who that is over there?
This is your boy, straight out of Gumbo Alpha Joe. You can find me on Facebook at Josef Alpha Man Pons, Instagram at Alexander the 83, and we outcha.
I heard that, man. He is outcha. And I swing my thing over to my right side, and who we got?
What's up, y'all? We got Jay Steele over here, keeping it real on the mic. Follow me on Instagram, Jesso Steele.
Y'all don't know how she, everything she does is just so sensual.
So cute.
And I swinging my thing over there to my far left, and who we got?
This is that actor guy, Martin Bats Bradford. You can find me on all your social media platforms at MisterBats. Spell that Mr. out, and you ain't gonna find you, boy. You dig? Sure. And I'm also representing the Fly with Bats podcast. Find us out here.
So you're right. Find him out here. And then who this is to my left?
Last but not least, the one and only Oshun. Please follow me on Instagram, Oshun, OshunSL11. Hit those DMs.
Yeah, shout out to him. Hit those DMs. Your DMs be popping, man. Shout out to Malik Bartholomew and Madani Graves.
Leaky Leak.
Mac. And Miss Susan Henry and all of our WBOK family. We're going to see y'all out there at the
Mastermind.
Fest. Mastermind.
I love Miss Susan. And all 39% of her.
No, that's a private conversation about how she's not all the way black. We ain't posting that on the radio. That ain't posting that on the radio. All right, but join us here next week, man. This is DC Paul, the Millennial Arsenio. Follow me at Slim Hotep. That's SlimHotep on Instagram, or just DC Paul on Facebook. In a few weeks, you can check out www.whoisdcpaul.com. Other than that, man, I'll be here every Saturday, so. Tune in and don't get nothing on you.
Well, I just got your Instagram name, so we can say that you're slightly Hotepish. Since you like you're Slim Hotep, so it's like you're not a full Hotep. You're not a Hotep. I'm just, you know, I might have a few.
I didn't think about it like that, but that fits too.
That can fit now.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because like I'm gonna be saying this.
I'm a Slim Hotep.
I'm a Slim. Right. Okay. I ain't even a medium Hotep here. I'm still Slim.
I'm still Slim with my Hotepery.
Yeah.
Right. I'm Slim Hotep.
All right, y'all, man. We see y'all next week.
Yeah.
This is a record I released on my EP. Purple in the sky, cruising highway 85. Thought I saw a shooting star, said be many and your aunt and I. Set Herbie Hancock on my radio. Oh, said let's pull over for the liquor store. Ay, said cop some Skittles and some Crown Royal. Ay, I know we ended things a week ago. Baby, pop into me slow. Hey, no, no love on me, baby. On that night drive. Ay. Ooh, you're so fine. Purple in the sky, cruising highway 85. Thought I saw a shooting star. Said be many and your aunt and I. Here.
All right. Hey.